So right now I'm in the process of removing Camo's shed, S-H-E-D, not S-H word. And there's a tomato worm, hornworm, whatever you call it. So we can eat it once, you know, I finish this stressful process and I use this thing as a spray to help, you know, take the old skin out easier. Got most of his old shed. Gosh, I'm really lucky to get footage of Camo eating right now because Camo is camera shy. And what's best is it's in slow motion, so that's cool. I really love this guy so much that I really want to show him off to everyone. This is not his real enclosure, by the way. I put him in this container when he kinda gets feeding shy and, you know, not run away in his enclosure so I can see him eat properly and when I have to clean the enclosure. Munch, 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 munch. Crunch, 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 crunch. Doesn't it just grind your gears that when in video games you had to fight one of these crazy bosses like a chameleon riding a giant supercharged high armored insect mech, and when you finally got their health point HP to half or maybe the most nearing close to zero, cutscene happens and now they split up and now you have to go up against them both at the same time, and one on the left, in this case the giant insect mech, high armored, all that, try to hurt you, and on the right the chameleon boss is waiting for when you are vulnerable to get you. And wait, there's more to add to the salt. When you least expect it and when you thought the game is already crazy enough, there's a giant hand out to get you from out of the sky! Congrats, now you have to watch the unskippable cutscenes over and over.
Alright. So, Camo fell asleep. This is not his enclosure, by the way. This is his cage when I'm cleaning his enclosure. His screen cage enclosure. I really don't want to bother him. He looks peaceful. This is the stuff I have to go through, you know, because it's nighttime and I'm like, should I don't want to leave him there, but I don't want to wake him. Now I wonder what he dreams about. And I still need to remove the shed. S-H-E-D, by the way, I'm not cursing, so on his head, he just gets freaked out if I remove it, or attempt to, at least. I'm going to wait a couple more minutes, you know, do something else, and then see if he's awake by then.